Here is a story that's just breaking hearts. The White House confirmed the man killed by ISIS terrorist was indeed American journalist Stephen Sotloff. Sotloff was the second American journalist to die at the hand of ISIS. Less than 15 minutes ago, we heard from reaction from Sotloff's family for the first time since his death.
Today we grieve. This week we mourn. But we will emerge from this ordeal. Our village is strong. We will not allow our enemies to hold us hostage with the sole weapons they possess, fear.
Our prayers go out. Sotloff was once a student at the University of Central Florida, and in just a few hours, students are set to hold a vigil, a candlelight vigil for him. News Channel 8's Holly Bounds joins us now with reaction from UCF's campus.
University of Central Florida journalism students are used to hearing talks about drive, passion, and risks that come with the profession.
Wanting to just reveal a story that nobody else knows that you want to get out there.
But it's hard for senior Kelsey Walker to comprehend just why Stephen Sotloff willingly put himself in the midst of such danger.
But there kind of has to be an extent that you stop and say, you know, my own safety. And I kind of wonder why he would put himself in that situation.
The tragedy of former UCF student Stephen Sotloff's execution by the Islamic State of Iraq and Greater Syria group has journalism professor Dr. Tim Brown answering some tough questions in the classroom.
Why was he so passionate about it? Why was he so committed to it? What was it about this that drove him? That's a question that an individual has to answer.
Brown plans to use the example of ISIS attacks on journalists lightly in class because they are rare and extreme, but it's a raw look at the sacrifice some give to share the stories he believes we so desperately need to hear.
I am making a point now of reading up on things I normally wouldn't have read because this has made me more aware of the lengths and the commitment that many journalists have to tell stories that matter.
That was Holly Bounds reporting from Orlando.